The well pump being fixed here is a half horsepower generic one made in China. The pump stopped working and just made a humming sound. I decided to use ratchet straps to stop the pump's main body from moving during the first part of disassembly. I would advise against using a vise to do this job, as you may damage the internal parts. Remove the stainless steel filter plate. This one is held in with two crosshead screws. The plastic base can be removed using a chain wrench, but some pumps require far more leverage. Now unscrew and remove the plastic base cap. A quick dry test and the pump still doesn't spin. Now to remove the C-clip from the main shaft with a small flat-headed screwdriver. Behind this clip there are three washers, one thicker one and two slim ones. Now to remove the diversion plates and the impellers. The lower three sets came out very easily. The fourth set has a seal around its edge. To get this out and avoid damaging the main shaft, I had to tap the outer cylinder on a raised floor using some old planks of wood. Off camera, I removed the rubber O-ring seal. Also within the housing, you should find a plastic ring that sits between the motor base and the rubber seal ring. Remove the upper cable clamp. Below this clamp, the cable is secured to the pump housing with a plate and two anti-tamper screws. I removed these screws using locking adjustable pliers, which was very time consuming. Pry upwards the cable plate and then wiggle out the internal cable with its rubber seal. Off camera, I cut the three cables. When doing this, leave at least 1.5 inches of slack on the side closest to the securing plate. The motor is now free to be pulled out of the pump cylinder housing. Spin the motor around and you will see the pump starter capacitor. Pull the capacitor free from its plastic clamp and anti-vibration sealant. As you can see, the white body of the capacitor is inflated, which is a classic sign of a blown capacitor, so this will be an easy fix. Non-spinning motors also suffer from worn brushes, or in the worst case scenario, burnt out armature windings. If the pump was used with very dirty water, one or more of the diversion plates or the impellers may be broken. In the case of a blown capacitor, note down its rating and seek a new one. This one is rated at 45 microfarads and 250 volts. I cut the capacitor cables and left some wire for reattaching the new capacitor. I tested the old capacitor and it had a reading of 0.361 microfarads. Here is the new capacitor, which I also tested before installing, and it reads 44.8 microfarads, which is within the tolerance of plus or minus 5%. This new capacitor cost me $13. The polarity doesn't matter for this type of starter capacitor. I reattached the new capacitor by inline twisting the copper wire strands and then soldering the joints. These joints are then insulated using heat shrink tubing. Place the capacitor back in its clamp. I used hot glue to stop the capacitor from moving, but you could also use acrylic or silicone sealant. I reattached the pump wiring temporarily to see if the motor would start. Only turn on the electricity for a second when doing this, as you shouldn't run a dry pump. Now to place the pump back in its housing and to feed the three electrical cables back through the upper hole. To make feeding the cable easier, I used some zip ties and a 15-inch piece of insulation tubing, but you could use string. Slide the motor back in the housing whilst pulling out the cable guide. Remove the cable guide. Now to solder and insulate the three wires. Feed the cable body back into its hole. With the pump standing vertically, pushing the cable body into its rubber seal. Reclamp the lower cable plate. I am using the original anti-tamper screws, but you could buy two new similar screws with crossheads. Reattach the upper cable clamp. Within the cylinder housing, place the plastic ring at the base of the motor with the flat side facing downwards. Place the rubber seal around the upper diversion plate. Insert the upper diversion plate, the seals and its impeller on the shaft. While pushing down the diversion plate, nudge down the seal around it bit by bit. To help me do this, I used a long flat-headed screwdriver. I had to do it this way as the seal is fairly tight. Now place back in order the three remaining sets of impellers and diversion plates. Back on with the three washers and the C-clip. The C-clip was loose, so off camera I reclosed it slightly using adjustable grips and then reattached it to the shaft. Screw back in the plastic base. Another quick dry test. Now for the water bucket test, and all is good. Make sure to record your pump's disassembly process so you can reference it when it comes to reassembly. I know your pump may not be built exactly the same as this one, but I hope this video helps in some way. If you have any comments or questions, please put them below. If the video was useful, please consider giving it a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.